Many a JLC member would like to see the Metropolitan Police Force accountable to County Hall and consider their police committee as a step towards that end. Mr. Reynolds is known to prefer private persuasion to public outcry, but he'll have to walk a tightrope between the Home Office-controlled status quo and the community-controlled police force called for by a growing number of pressure groups. Tower Hamlets has a community alliance for police accountability. It's become the prototype for a chain of monitoring groups across London. £12,000 GLC provides and equips an office and pays a worker who coordinates 30 volunteers offering basic legal advice and general help to people in custody.
And how old is he? He's 16. And what police station did he get taken to?
Kappa has averaged 10 calls a month, one this weekend.
We offer any time of the day or night legal backup, which means finding out exactly what's happened at the police station and getting somebody out of the police station and getting them legal representation in court.
How would you answer critics who say you're out to hamper the police?
Well, we don't want to hamper the police. We want the police to behave within the law properly and effectively to serve the interests of this community.
Post Scarman, the Home Secretary, favoured voluntary liaison between police chiefs and councils. He's since moved towards the Scarman call for statutory liaison, but the idea of legislation could be lost within the Home Office if an agreement's reached soon. Voluntary or statutory, it's unlikely to include the Cappers of London.
We made a decision not to indulge in cosy tea party style chats with the police because there have been plenty of those for years and they haven't achieved anything.
David Bellin for Thames News.
Acted the community that it was serving, rather than a police force which treated certain members of its community with contempt.